Cody is a new robotic process automation, RPA, that helps to automate some activities in the pre-award phase of the acquisition lifecycle. Cody has two paths. Path one is for use after the receipt of proposals, and it automates the offer checklist and the contractor responsibility review process. Path two automates functions of award preparation, which includes a final vendor report, a draft responsibility memo, and handles Pegasus codes for your potential awardee. In this training, we will cover these two pathways in more detail. Let's start with path one, contractor responsibility report and offer checklist. To use this pathway, you must submit a request to the Cody request form located on the OAM Automation Center website. Upon the receipt of proposals, you will navigate to the Cody request form and fill in your region. Select Contractor Responsibility Report and Offer Checklist, fill in your solicitation number, procurement title, NAICS code, and unique entity identifier or UEI numbers of your offerers. If you have received multiple proposals, you'll include all of the UEI numbers on this form and separate the numbers by a semicolon. Cody will then collect data from several federal data sites, including SAM.gov, DSBS.SBA.gov, USAspending.gov, and FPDS.gov. Cody will aggregate the data and create a detailed PDF report for each offerer you have submitted, and will reply to your request via email with an overview of the vendors you submitted, along with a contractor responsibility report and an offer checklist. This contractor responsibility report includes a table of contents with hyperlinks for easy navigation for each data source. The cover page provides the date when the report was run and contains a summary of key details for the vendor, including their UEI, legal business name, registered address, and suitability subject areas. Cody also aggregates important vendor details for all submitted vendors in an Excel offer checklist file. The offer checklist summarizes responses to key reps and certs findings for all vendors into a single checklist document. Cody will also include a 3-year award history from FPDS for each vendor as a separate tab on the checklist. This means you'll have a full award history to reference as needed during your evaluations. If Cody detects that any of your UEIs are either invalid or inactive in SAM.gov, you will receive a caution message in your email, instructing you to verify the accuracy of your submitted UEIs and verify results before taking negative action. You will also receive two versions of letters for each inactive vendor or invalid UEI submission for use at your discretion: a time extension letter and an award ineligibility letter, which are options provided under Acquisition Alert AA-2021-03. If your vendor is inactive, you'll receive a contractor responsibility report along with the letters. But if your UEI is invalid, you'll only receive the letters. To maximize Cody's performance and response times, you can submit up to 10 vendors with each form submission. If you receive more than 10 offers, that's okay. You can submit multiple forms for your solicitation with 10 or fewer UEIs per form submission. In the procurement title field of the form submission, you can write something like Office Renovation, Group 1 of 2, and Office Renovation, Group 2 of 2, to help you keep track. Now that you're ready to use Path 1, we'll move to Path 2, Awardee Memorandum and Preparation. This pathway should be used when you have identified your potential awardee. You will again use the Cody request form, but this time, you'll select the Awardee Memorandum and Preparation pathway. When you submit this request, Cody will use the report from Path 1 and the information in your form submission to draft and fill in portions of a contractor responsibility memo. Cody will also look up the active Pegasus vendor code and vendor address code for the prospective awardee. If no active code is available, Cody will submit a Pegasus vendor code request on your behalf, so that your award will not be delayed for this reason. You will again receive Cody's response via email. It will include an overview of your request and the vendor's information, as well as their active Pegasus vendor code and vendor address code. If your vendor does not have an active Pegasus vendor code, you will see a confirmation that Cody submitted a request on your behalf and get copied on the vendor code activation request to Fort Worth Finance. When this code is activated, Fort Worth Finance will email the information to you separately. Just like the first pathway, if Cody detects that your UEI was invalid or inactive in SAM.gov, you will see a caution message in your email to verify the accuracy of your submission and verify results before taking any negative action. You will also receive two versions of letters for use at your discretion, a time extension letter and an award ineligibility letter. You are now ready to use paths 1 and 2 of Cody, but there's one important disclaimer to keep in mind. Business disclaimer. Cody's contractor responsibility report, offer checklist, and responsibility memo are aggregations of data. It does not substitute for the contracting officer's duty to assess the results and responsibility of the vendor. Take the steps being asserted in the responsibility memo and finalize the memo. Within Cody's reports and emails, you will see this message emphasized in multiple places, along with markings identifying the documents as source selection information. In cases where Cody does detect negative findings, such as exclusion or debarment records, the CO should independently verify. A non-responsibility determination would need to be supplemented beyond this automation report. Conclusion. This concludes the Cody training. For more information, please visit Cody's page on the OAM Automation Center, where you can read details and submit questions or suggestions on the bot feedback form. You can also email directly to Cody@gsa.gov. Your feedback will be used as Cody grows in the future to further support the acquisition workforce.